A former Air Force combat veteran running for Congress in Texas, and MJ Hegar, her latest ad has gone viral with nearly 2 million views in just 5 days.
This is a story about doors. A lot of them. And that's me, MJ Hegar, an Air Force combat veteran and a mom. This door behind me is from my Pave Hawk helicopter. It's all that's left of the aircraft that I was flying that day. I was on a rescue mission in Afghanistan as a combat search and rescue pilot. I heard the windshield crack and realized I'd been shot. But I continued the mission and airlifted the patients out. After taking even more fire, we crashed a few miles away. But my story begins much earlier. One of my first memories was of a door, but it was my dad throwing my mom through a glass window. 3 years later, mom got the courage to walk out the door, and she opened a new one for my sister and me here in Texas. And it was here that I put my foot on the gas and followed my dream to be a pilot. And that meant opening, pushing, sometimes kicking through every door that was in my way.
And MJ Hegar joins us now. Major, thank you so much for being with us. What message do you want to send with that ad, 2 million views and counting, and what do you make of the reception it's received?
I think we need to elect people who are more reflective of the districts they come from. My district has more veterans in it than 97% of the rest of the country, and our current congressman hasn't served and has failed the veterans in his district. So I'm trying to let people know that I'm one of them. I'm representative of the district that I've grown up in my whole life. And I'm hoping, I think that part of the reason it's been so well received is because the message resonates with people. A lot of people across the country feel like they have absent representation and that their voices are not being heard.
So we'll let people go online and see the ad themselves if they're interested in that. Let's talk about some of the issues of the day that are so important, particularly in your state of Texas where you're running right now. The border, very much an issue. The president signed the executive order suggesting he no longer wants to separate children from their parents at the border. What do you think should happen to parents who cross the border, not at legal checkpoints, but cross the border in between with children? Should they be detained indefinitely as families?
Well, I think that there's a big difference between, you know, people who are just crossing the border illegally and those that are seeking asylum. And I think that there should never be a policy of separating families, especially just as a deterrent. I think that we can secure our border in smarter ways with technology and resources and not with terror. And I think that these types of policies are damaging to our military. It damages our reputation, and our reputation on the world stage and how we deal with our allies is something that saves lives in American in uniform.
So the administration says it's not separating parents from children who go through the designed checkpoints. If they don't go through a checkpoint, do you feel that the parents should be held with their children, alongside their children, indefinitely?
Yeah, I think that the policy is not necessarily the problem. I mean, I have issues with the policy, but the implementation, I think, is representative of a broader problem that we have when we talk about immigration and is reflective of the broken legislative branch, frankly. I think that, you know, we need to do all we can to keep people safe and keep families together. We see the same thing with Dreamers. Mm-hmm. We have a lot of veterans that are Dreamers that get deported because, deported away from their families. And then they can't get VA services for the wounds that they sustained in combat, serving our country, or for PTSD and what have you. And just a broader, we need to elect people that can work together on real solutions and understand that security and compassion are not mutually exclusive.
So Congress, where you want to go, may or may not have a vote on immigration reform this week. It's very unlikely to pass anything substantive. Let's talk about your Democratic leadership, prospective leadership. If you win, would you support Nancy Pelosi to be the Democratic leader, whether the minority leader or Speaker of the House?
You know, I don't know that that's a question that anybody in my district is really asking. I've knocked on thousands of doors and received, you know, over 20,000 responses to the video, and not a single one has been about this. So I think this is a D.C. question.
Well, it is a question you will have to face.
Sure. Eventually, and we'll know who she's running against, and then I can make an informed decision on who is going to represent my district better. I'm going to always vote for the values of my district and what I think is best for them. I will say that, I come from a military culture in which we rotate our leadership out every 2 or 3 years in different positions, and I think that that's healthy.
You talked about the discourse in this country right now. It's been a heck of a weekend in terms of discourse. Look, it's been a heck of a few years in terms of discourse in this country, but Sarah Sanders, the White House press secretary, she was not allowed in, or she was sent out of a restaurant where she was eating. Do you think that What did you make of that decision? Do you think that helps the discourse that we're trying to have in this country?
I think that it's another example of something that makes people turn the television off when we start talking about politics, and that's hypocrisy. I think that people on both sides of the aisle will be for or against something depending on which party it impacts, and I don't think that that's right. I will say that there, I'm disturbed by the parallels that are being drawn to discriminating against same-sex couples and things like that, because your political beliefs and your integrity and your character doesn't make you a protected class.
Major MJ Hegar, thank you so much for being with us. Look, thank you for your service. Independent of what happens to you politically, we owe you a debt of gratitude for everything you've done for this country. We appreciate you being with
us this
morning.
Thank you so much. Thanks, John.
MJ Hegar.